student scholars in association with Goa Headmasters Association.
Hello students, in the previous class we started with the chapter construction, and in that we had learned how to divide a line segment in the given ratio using two methods. We also started with construction of triangles similar to a given triangle based on scale factor. Now you know scale factor is the ratio of the sides of the triangle to be constructed with the corresponding sides of the given triangle. So based on scale factor we had two situations. First one, when the scale factor was less than 1. In that we saw that the triangle that we constructed was smaller than the given triangle. So this we had already covered in the last class. Today we will see the second case where the scale factor is greater than 1. Now when the scale factor is greater than 1, we know scale factor is in the form of a ratio. So it can be written as A upon B. And when A upon B is greater than 1, we know that the numerator is greater than the denominator. And in this case, the triangle that we will be constructing will be larger than the given triangle. So let us see a question based on it. So we have a question over here where you have to use a pair of compasses and ruler. Construct triangle DEF with sides DE is equal to 5 cm, angle D is equal to 60 degrees, and DF is equal to 4.5 cm. So this is the given triangle. Then we need to construct triangle DE dash F dash similar to triangle DEF whose sides are 5 by 3 of the corresponding sides of triangle DEF. So let us begin with the construction. So first we need to draw a rough figure for it. So rough figure has to be drawn freehand. Next we need to name it. Now if you see over here, angle D is 60 degrees. So angle will come on the base. So vertex D will come on the base. So it is DEF. Next, write the measurements. So DE is 5 cm. Angle D is given as 60 degrees. And DF is 4.5 cm. So now let us begin with the actual construction. So first we need to draw the base DE. So DE is given as 5 cm. Let us name it DE. Next we need to construct angle D which is 60 degrees. And here we have to use only pair of compasses and ruler in order to construct angle 60 degrees. So you are not using protractor over here. So take a pair of compass. Take a fixed radius, so I will take 2 cm, keep it on point D and cut the arc. Next, without disturbing, shift it to the point where the arc meets side DE and cut another arc. So you see that both the arcs intersect at a point. Next we need to join point D and the point where the arcs intersect. So next to get vertex F, we will have to take a pair of compass. Take D as the center. And take the radius as 4.5 cm. Keep it on point D. And cut the arm of the angle. So the point where the arc cuts the arm of the angle is point F. So next, in order to complete the triangle, we need to join point E and point F. So we have a triangle DEF. So this is a given triangle. Next, we need to construct the triangle similar to this given triangle. So for that, we will have to draw a ray through point D. Now, why through point D? Now, if you see, the triangle that we need to construct is triangle DE dash F dash. And the triangle given to us is triangle DEF. Now, I told you last time that we need to look for a common vertex. And in this case, the common vertex is D. So, we will draw the ray through point D. So, let us name it ray DY. Now, you have to see that the angle that is formed, that is angle EDY, should be an acute angle. Next, we need to mark points on ray DY. Now, how many points on ray DY? If you see here, the scale factor given to us is 5 by 3. So, you have to look for a number greater among the two. So, there is 5 and there is 3. And we know that the greater number is 5. So, we are going to mark 5 points on ray DY. For that, you will need a pair of compass. The points have to be marked at equal intervals, that is keeping the distance same. So, take a fixed distance. So I will take 2 centimeter. Keep it on point D to cut the first arc, shift it down to get the second arc, and similarly you need to cut 3 more arcs. So, we have marked 5 points on ray DY. Let us name them D1, D2, D3, D4 and D5. Next, we will be joining point E to one of these points on ray DY. Now, which point? Now, if you see here, the scale factor given is 5 by 3. So, you have to check for the denominator. Denominator is given as 3. So, we will be joining point E and point D3. So, we have joined point E and point D3. Next, we need to draw a line parallel to ED3 through point D5. Now, why through D5? Because the numerator given to us is 5. So, the scale factor is 5 by 3 and in that case, the numerator is 5. So, next, we need to draw a line through point D5 which will be parallel to line ED3. For that, first we need to mark an angle at point D5 which will be again equal to angle ED3D. So, take a pair of compass, take a fixed distance. So, now I will take 1.5 centimeter. First, keep it on point D3 to cut the first arc. Next, shift it to point D5 to get the second arc. Next, Next, we need to measure this angle that I've marked in red. So for that, you will need to adjust your compass accordingly. Shift it to the arc that we have drawn through point D5. And cut the arc. So we see that both the arcs intersect at a point. So when you will join point D5 and the point where the arcs intersect, so for that you will have to first extend side DE, because in this case we know that the scale factor is 5/3, it is greater than 1. So the triangle that we are going to construct will be larger than the given triangle. So for that we will have to extend side DE. So take a ruler, keep it on point E. And extend side DE. So next we will join point D5 and the point where the arcs intersect, such that when you extend it, it will meet the extended part of side DE. So next when we join point D5 and the point where the arcs intersect, when you extend it further, it meets the extended part of side DE at point E dash. So we have a line parallel to ED3, that is E dash D5. Next we need to draw a parallel line to EF through point E dash. So for that, again you need to mark an angle at point E dash, which will be equal to angle FED. So take a pair of compass, take the distance as 1.5 centimeter, keep it on point E, to cut an arc without disturbing, shift it to point E dash to cut the second arc. Next, using a pair of compass, you need to measure this angle. Adjust your compass accordingly. And shift it to the arc that you have cut through point E dash. And cut the arc. Next, you need to join point E dash and the point where the arcs intersect in order to get a line parallel to EF. So extend it and it will meet the extended part of side DF. And the point where it meets the extended part of side DF is point F dash. So we have constructed triangle DE dash F dash, which is larger than the given triangle. Next, students, quickly go through the steps that we used to construct this triangle where the scale factor was greater than 1. And we also saw that the triangle that we constructed was larger than the given triangle. Next, we are going to see how to construct tangents to a circle from a point outside the circle. Now, what are tangents? Tangents are the line segment that meet or intersect the circle at one and only one point. So, we will see how to construct tangents to a circle when the point is outside the circle. So, we have a question over here where we have to draw a circle with center O and radius 3 cm. Then take a point P at a distance of 8 cm from the center of the circle. Using a pair of compasses and ruler only, construct two tangents PA and PB to the circle. Measure and state the length of the tangent segments. So first we will draw a circle of radius 3 cm. It is a good habit to first mark the center so that you don't juggle with it later. So we have to take radius 3 cm. Keep it on point O, that is the center of the circle, and draw the circle. So we have a circle with center O and radius 3 cm. Next, we need to take a point P at a distance of 8 cm from the center of the circle. So for that, we will need a ruler. So keep it on point O and measure 8 cm. Let us mark point P. Next, we need to construct perpendicular bisector for segment OP. Take a pair of compass, measure more than half of the length of segment OP in order to cut the arcs. So first keep it on point O, cut the first arc and one below. Next, shift it to point P. In order to intersect both the arcs, so you see that both the arcs are intersecting at two distinct points. We need to join them in order to get the perpendicular bisector. So we have constructed a perpendicular bisector for segment OP, and we know that perpendicular bisector divides segment OP into two equal halves. So the point where it meets segment OP is a midpoint. So let us name it as point M. Next, we need to take a pair of compass. Taking M as the center and radius equal to MP or MO, So we have taken M as the center and radius equal to MP or OM, and draw another circle such that it will intersect our previously drawn circle at two distinct points. So we will name the points as point A and point B. So next we need to join point A and point P to get the first tangent, and then B and P to get the second tangent. So we have marked the first tangent, that is PA. So we have the second tangent, that is PB. Next we need to measure both the tangents, that is PA and PB. So take a ruler, check the length of PB. I have 7.3 centimeter. Similarly, I will check the length of the other tangent, that is PA. So even here it measures as 7.3 centimeter. So therefore we say that both the tangents, that is PA is equal to PB, which is equal to 7.3 centimeter. So length of both the tangent segments are equal. This is based on the theorem from chapter circle, which states that the length of the tangent segments drawn to the circle from an external point are equal. So here also we have proved the same, that the tangents PA and PB, which were drawn from a point lying outside the circle, that is point P, are equal in length. Students, quickly go through the steps that we use to construct two tangents from a point outside the circle. Next, we have one more question over here based on construction of tangents, which says that draw line segment AB, which is 10 centimeter. Taking A as center, draw a circle of radius 4 centimeter, and taking B as center, draw another circle of radius 3 centimeter. Construct tangents to each circle from the center of the other circle. So first we will draw the line segment AB, which is of 10 centimeter. So we have segment AB, which is of 10 centimeter. Next, we have been told to take A as the center and draw a circle of radius 4 centimeter. Take a compass. Take the radius as 4 centimeter. Keep it on point A and draw the circle. Next, we need to take B as the center and draw another circle of radius 3 centimeter. So take your pair of compass, measure 3 centimeter as the radius, keep it on point B and draw the second circle. So we have two circles, one with center A and radius 4 cm, second one with center B and radius 3 cm. Next, we need to construct perpendicular bisector for segment AB. Keep it on point A and measure more than half of the length of AB. Cut an arc, keeping on point A. Next, shift it to point B. To intersect both the arcs, so you see that the arcs are intersecting at two distinct points. We need to join them in order to get the perpendicular bisector. So we have constructed the perpendicular bisector for segment AB, and it meets segment AB at a point, and we know that point is the midpoint of segment AB. So let us name it as point X. Next, you need a pair of compass. Take X as the center and radius equal to XB or XA. So when you take X as the center and radius equal to XB or XA, draw another circle such that it will intersect the previously drawn circles at two distinct points each. So let us name these points, point P, Q, R, and S. So next you have to construct tangents to each circle from the center of the other circle. So if I take this first circle with center A and radius 4 cm. So if this is my first circle and I need to draw tangents to this circle, so I'll have to take the center of the second circle, that is point B. So in order to draw tangents to the first circle, you will have to join point P and point B, similarly point Q and point B. So we have got the first tangent, that is PB. So we have constructed two tangents, PB and QB, to circle with center A from a point which is outside the circle, that is, we have considered the center of the other circle, that is point B. Similarly, we need to now construct tangents to circle with center B, which is of radius 3 cm, from the center of the other circle, that is from point A. So for that, we will have to join point A and point S. Similarly, point A and point R. So when you have joined point A and point S, you get the next tangent, that is AS. Similarly, you need to join point A and point R. So we have got tangent AS and AR to the circle with center B from the center of the other circle, that is point A. So in this case, we have four tangents. Therefore, the required tangents are BP, BQ, AR and AS. So in this case, we have seen construction of four tangents. So students, quickly go through the steps that we use to construct four tangents, that is tangents to each circle from the center of the other circle. So students, in today's class, we have learned to construct triangles similar to a given triangle where the scale factor was greater than 1. In that case, we have seen that the triangle that we constructed was larger than the given triangle. We also learned to construct tangents to a circle from a point outside the circle. And in that case, we have seen construction of two tangents and construction of four tangents. Remember students, in construction, practice is the only key to make it perfect. So keep practicing to be perfect with it. Thank you and have a pleasant day.